That was embarrassing. See, what I would say about Clement is, generally, you look at the performances, you look at the results, he's done a phenomenal job since he's came in, when he's not had a squad to pick from, right? So he's been limited because of injuries, he's had to pick the best 11 he's got at hand, and he's done very well with that, right? But he's also never put one word wrong in press conferences. But that comment about a moral victory, that was embarrassing. What are you talking about? The bottom line is, mate, this guy picked Scott Wright to start for Rangers when he had other options. He had Cantwell on the bench, and that baffles me. And I know what you're saying, Roger, about highlighting Scott Wright because he got took off. I'm highlighting the guy not because he got took off, but because he's an awful player that should never wear our shirt.
That was the I saw a start last night, Stephen. I think he's played 9 Old Firm games, but that was the first one he had actually started. He came off the bench for the rest. Yeah. You're right about Clement. He's done well since he's been in. He's got the results that he's needed. He may well continue to get the results he's needing at Dens Park and at Dingwall in the next week. But what he hasn't done yet, he's not, as you would say, picked a team that's managed to beat Celtic. And he's going to have to go, not necessarily beat Celtic, but he's going to have to go and get a positive result at Celtic Park after the split. Whether he thinks a draw does him to match yesterday's draw, I don't know. I'll be fascinated to see what front three he goes with at Celtic Park, because like you, I'm not convinced that environment is the one you would put Scott Wright into. And I'm actually not sure it's one you would put Fabio Silva into either, you know, after his antics yesterday. I just wonder if Rangers might go to Celtic Park with pace and power and Sima and Dessers and Matondo.
Was it a moral victory for Rangers, Andy?
I can understand why he said it immediately after the game, because, well, myself, I don't know if Roger felt the same way. I thought Rangers were dead and buried at half time. Didn't see them getting back into the game at all. And then when they eventually get back to equalise it 2-2 and Adamida scores to make it 3-2 in the 88th minute, a minute later, then of course Rangers would take a point. But then you step back and you think of the magnitude of the league going forward. I think, no doubt for me, the draw benefits Celtic more than it does Rangers.